Pope Francis has said that pastors who are good shepherds should have the smell of the sheep, because they share their lives with their communities and are with them in good times and in bad. They are one with them. They know their people's aspirations and their needs, supporting them in their challenges and in their struggles.
It's important for a priest working in a diocese like Tucson to have a missionary spirit, willing to go into a remote area, willing to work in challenging circumstances. To bring his expertise, to bring his talent, to bring the special gifts God has given him, to work for the people. Ministry is challenging, and it's important that our priests realize that they're not in this alone. Our reservation here, the Tohono-O'odham Reservation, is as big as the state of Connecticut, so it's a very large space. Catholic Extension has helped us support our priests in outlying areas. Without that support, I don't know how we could have a priest serving in those remote areas, which are perhaps the most needed places for priests to give people hope and a future and nurture their faith. At least a third of our parishes can't afford to pay the stipend of their priest, because they are communities where there's little work. Most people are on fixed incomes. So organizations like Catholic Extension are tremendously helpful to our mission diocese to provide the support so that there can be a priest there.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
It's unfortunate they don't always get a great sense of the liturgical seasons, because you're not having a Sunday Mass all the time. I find a lot of my preaching is catechetical, a lot of explanation, and try to put the gospel and the readings in context, in the larger context of the season.
The priests bring to the community a lot. They make us unite in the times of our celebration, to gather and to learn to be one. Like they say, you gotta believe and dream, and God will answer your prayers. It may be slow, but you get your answers through the Holy Spirit.
Sure. 85% of the O'odham are Catholic. Tohono means desert, so they're a desert people. We have 40 chapels. Now there are two friar priests. I'm one of them. Most of the villages at this point, even now, only have Mass once a month. They want you to be present with them. Luckily, we have great lay leadership. The teachings of the church very much dovetail into what is their traditional culture, which is they call the Himadag, which English translation is closest is the culture. But it's really a way of life, the whole way of life, and their values. Both very much are in sync with the gospel. And so that's why it was really not very difficult for the O'odham to enter the church. The people have always been here, and they see their culture, and they see their life, and their stories. Their life is here, in the desert. Even in the midst of the many struggles and the realities that now immigration, the border issues, and drug trafficking, and we're ground zero.
in a mission diocese like ours, we don't have a lot of resources. We don't have a Catholic university. We don't have a Catholic seminary. We have a shortage of priests. And so many times a priest has to wear different hats, and the ministry kind of stretches you. So your days don't go from 8 to 4. They go way longer. They go beyond your parish limits because of this shortage of priests, because of this shortage of resources. You go and you help out your brother priest in doing the mission in these different realities, immigration, border diocese. And that, in a sense, keeps you very alive and very aware of what it means to be church. I truly do believe that faith can transform society, because faith gets you closer to what's real.
As a Catholic Church, of course, the Eucharist is central to us. And my hope and prayer is that we will have sufficient priests to be able to minister in all of our communities, because no matter how small a community may be, no matter how remote a community may be, they need to know that God is with them, that God is there for them, and that the Eucharist is one way that that message can be strongly delivered. Well, Catholic Extension has been an incredible help to this diocese. I don't know where our diocese would be without the support of Extension. The faith of our native peoples is very deep. We're all united. And one of the most beautiful experiences I've had on the reservation is a prayer where there's an elderly person, there's a very young person, there's sort of a middle-aged person, and they're carrying ropes. And they dance around in such a way that they intertwine these ropes, all the while singing, "Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with ropes that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together." And it's that sense of unity, of belonging, that is so powerful. It's something I think we can all learn from. We're one family, because in the church, you know, there is really only one family in Christ.
"For this is my body, which will be given up for you."
"This is my body, which will be given up for you."
The San Solano Missions are among the most economically disadvantaged parishes in the Diocese of Tucson. Catholic Extension supports these ministries so that everyone has the chance to experience the joy of the gospel and to partake in the Eucharist.